Once again, we thank you, though we've interacted in the past on various forums. It's always been an honor to be present addressing you people for work which SPICE has been doing. In this particular avatar of mine, I also look after the 139 services for the Indian Railways. This is a public-private partnership launched by us 5 years back. It was awarded to a consortium led by SPICE, PANCO and BSNL. There were various people who bid for this tender initially. During the course of these 5 years, we have tried to service people to the best of our abilities. We run a contact center with 300 people, servicing people primarily on the IVR. We are present across 4 regions. We put together a small presentation telling you as to how this works, what Bharat BPO, which is the company which addresses the 139 services. Mr. Rajesh Sirke is our head of operations. So I'd also asked him, requested him that he also should be a part of this. Let me just take you through a presentation. The dilemma faced by all of us during the course was when we had to remember multiple numbers. Today, like when we travel by the airlines, we have to remember the Jet Airways number, we have to remember the SpiceJet number, we have to remember the Air India number, among others. And it's a tall ask. Imagine when there were 5,000 odd numbers for the railways. So when you were traveling from Bombay, there was a different number. From Ahmedabad, there was a different number. From the south, across 70 odd locations, there are different numbers. So 5,000 numbers to be remembered by people was something which was becoming very difficult. As per the national numbering policy of the telecom, it was decided that the 130 series till 139 would be awarded to the Indian Railways, which is with them. So when the tender was finalized and it was pegged to us, we started the 139 service, which today has become synonymous with the railways for rail travel. So today it's a short code which is available on SMS, USSD, as well as in the voice format. Anybody can just pick up a mobile phone. There's no STD code which has to be put in. You just dial 139 and I could give a live demo subsequently if required. And you get access to the IVR, which tells you that we're going to talk to you either in English or Hindi, depending upon the location which you come from, in addition to 9 more languages. So English, Hindi is the predominant language which we address people in. When a person feels that he does not get a satisfactory answer on the IVR, he gets transferred on to the agent. A call which is unique, which I think some of you have experienced, is picked up in 3 seconds. In the last, I think, 5 years, we've been awarded every award of its reckoning within the government, within the private and the public sector. This is one award which you're not ever wired for. And after talking to the team at Aegis, we thought that we must take up the opportunity and see if we could compete in the challenging role and try to see if we could work out wonders for ourselves. Who are we? Basically, that is what everybody's been wanting to know in the past, because we've kept a profile which has been low. We don't speak about it because even the name, it's a Bharat BPO services. Bharat was a name awarded to us, keeping in mind it was a service to the nation where we pay the railways as an obligation every year. Quite to the contrary, the other way the businesses work. We are a basic service provider of information to the railway commuter today. We address about 55 crore commuters in the month. That is the amount of people who are traveling every month by Indian Railways. We are a bankable travel companion which has been ascertained by people. We're also a powerful advertising channel. That's where we get our monies from. We are also trying to establish a credible connect with the population at large, because people across languages who would like to speak to you really do not know that if I can speak in a language which is other than English and Hindi. So it is predominant that we put in Tamil, Telugu, Kannada on one side. We have Assamese and Bengali on the other side. We are now introducing Punjabi into the flow of things. We've got Gujarati and Marathi also established. Bharat BPO is, we address the world's largest railway network in this country. And keeping in mind there are 2 crore people traveling every day by train. So it's a huge population which you're supposed to be addressing. We have 2 kind of audiences. We are really looking at the internal audience, because we are supposed to be looking at challenging roles within partners. So a person who had the expertise of running the zonal data centers in terms of looking after the software part was PANCO, which is a well-known name itself in the market. SPICE, a Dr. B.K. Modi-led group, which is what we represent, has been in the space for about 30 odd years in the telecom space also. And railways for us, for the external audience, because we are addressing customers, we are the interface. some facts about what we do. We were incorporated in 2006. Our business was to run Rail Sampark. That's the only job which we do under this business called Bharat BPO Services. We have 9 languages in addition to English and Hindi. We have over 350 people. We were sitting on a 1600 team size. We toned it down to make sure efficiencies work on the IVR. Otherwise, everything was working in the agent. So we said, when we are in the automated space, let's try to see how do we give better services in a restricted environment. We have a seat capacity which we can take up to 700. We support all types of voice, fax, SMS, and USDT calls. So all your telecom operators are already there on these services with us. We have approximately 16 lakh connects every day with the customer in terms of voice. We have about 4 million connects on SMS on a daily basis, is the kind of volumes which we speak of. And this is all incoming. We are operating 24/7, 365. We are at Noida, Mysore, Ahmedabad, and Kolkata in terms of the regional call centers where the agents are sitting out. The zonal data centers are at the premise of the railways itself in Delhi, Bombay, in this case, Chennai, and Calcutta. So these are the languages which we talk to people in: Hindi, English, Bengali, Odia, Assamese, Marathi and Gujarati, Tamil, Telugu, Kannada and Malayalam, now Punjabi, which would be introduced on Monday. The organization has a domain knowledge in travel and tourism space, because of which we have a pan-India reach. Because of operations, because of the call center operations which we had in terms of Spice BPO in the past, we also ran the Air India service called 1407, right? So we had that expertise, so we thought it best and appropriate to move into 139 after that. We have got state-of-the-art technology. We work on the MPLS across regions. Our failure rate has been negligible, 0.001% has been the failure rate in the business over the 5 years. Not a single customer complaints have come in for funny things where information provided to customers is what we pass on, because we take it on the back end on real time from the railways. So if I am the agent at Ambala and I'm not filled in the data at my end when the train is past me, the Sonipat person sitting at Sonipat or Panipat will not have that lag of approximately 20 odd minutes. So that information could suffer. So they said, why are we getting wrong information? So we have corrected that. Now you can spot your train wherever it is. You can just put in the SMS, put in the keyword, or when you speak to the agent at our level, you get the information on a real-time basis. So traveling from Bombay to Delhi across all stations, you can get the information what train has left the station, what time and what platform is going to come to. So that is the accuracy we're working on right now.
Still
physical? Both ways, sir. Even on the IVR as well as on the agent now.
The spotting of the train and location of the train is physical?
Yes, but that's physical.
Yes.
From the other side, it's physical.
Yes.
We have a huge customer database. We have what's
updates the data every time.
No. Chris does the automation. Central reservation information system.
Train has passed from this place to this place.
That is physical.
That is also done physical. Now they're changing on to the GPS part.
Yes. Now
that is getting introduced now.
Is a very challenging.
Oh, it's very challenging. Very challenging.
Difficult and challenging job.
That's why we now need to go to the next level, which is technology here.
In fact, yes. You're right. In fact, this spot the train service is on GPS. It has not covered all trains, but I think as of now, the railway has covered around 50% of all routes. So it is on GPS now. The spot the train feature which has been introduced. Yes. Yes. So like I said, your pan-India presence is there. Right? All telecom operators move in. BSNL carries the call for all the operators. So in typically Bombay and Delhi, the call is lands on MTNL. MTNL services the calls from there. Well, this is a small picture which actually says, yes, people are satisfied with the service across, and it's brought a smile to most people, including the railways, which is very tough to please. We moved on for, 4 lakhs was much later. We moved on for something like 15,000 calls, moving up to 40,000 calls, moving up to 50. And now we are looking at reaching approximately 20 lakh calls a day is the service. But the only surprising thing is that 20 lakh calls also a very small volume. because the passenger traveling is about 2 crores per day. So we want to reach, how do we reach the rest of the people? Who do they ask for an inquiry? They have to go to that same queue. They have to ask the same coolie, ki bhaiya train kaun se platform pe aane wali hai. And if it's delayed, he's waiting for 4 hours at the station. So when the Honorable Minister long back announced that, he said, I would like to keep everybody into a sphere where you work in a JIT, and a just-in-time kind of an approach, where you reach the airport 45 minutes and 1 hour before the airline. Why do you reach 4 and 5 hours and try to make a security hazard at the railway stations? So we're trying to see that, how does that communication reach to them? Tall ask.
Well, it's also a question of educating the mass population. Now, I'll give you my example. My wife was coming back from Calcutta, and I kept calling her, where is your train? Whereas I could have automatically called your service.
Absolute.
And got the location of the train.
But as a rule, it's not you, it's all of us. We always call up the service, and then we also call up the passenger, whoever's coming. Listen, are you really there?
Trust level is yet to
be. It is different. It's always different. It's always different because you really want to know if it's running right. Because
that is a trust. And second, what is telling, we are not aware also. That is education.
Absolutely.
But
you're absolutely right.
So both things
work in tandem. Now, Rajesh, he has sleepless nights when he knows that somebody from my family is traveling, because he knows I'm going to call up and I'm going to ask all sorts of questions other than to the train which is coming in. So, train is going to come in at 6 o'clock in the morning. So, I want to know what time is it left that place, where is this person, what platform is it coming at, why haven't you spoken to me in English when I'm dialing a number and saying you have to speak to me in English. So, all these challenges come up, you know, because suddenly the call volume spurts. Rainy seasons, which we all aware of, trains get delayed by 12 hours, 14 hours and 15 hours.
And during fog,
so you really do not know if at the last moment, because train tracking and systems which are done by the railways, it's decided, all computerized, so you know which platform it's supposed to come. But if the trains are delayed, the platforms keep changing, right? So that information is something which we provide at the back end afterwards. We started off with basic inquiry service because the tender specification was, we needed to give basic inquiry services, value-add services and premium inquiry services. Most of the services are supposed to be completed in the IVR. Initially, because of creating the interest, we said, okay, let the questions be answered by the option by giving direct access to the agent, which we have again reintroduced. So today, when you call up the service, you can speak to the IVR, put in your information and go to the agent afterwards. Because at the end of the day, whoever the customer, he feels more comfortable speaking on a one-to-one basis to somebody who he can hear a voice with. So the PNR, which is the most widely questioned service where people have inquiries, what is the PNR? Maximum number of calls come in there. Train arrival, departure, maximum number of queries come in over there. We service about 80-84% people in Hindi.
You're right.
Today. Right? So we want people to hear the full menu, because I may not know how to speak Hindi. I may be coming from a different part of the country. I would only like to speak in Bengali and Assamese. But in the IVR flow, I've got the option 1 and 2. So I say, oh, Hindi, easy. So let me go to Hindi. I don't wait for Assamese and Bengali to happen. So we're trying to now educate the customer again, because it's going to carry on next for the 5 years, because the tender is for 10 years. And inshallah, it'll carry on much later too. We are saying, educate the customer that you can speak to a person in your own language, because his comfort levels actually change.
And the call is consumed quicker.
That's right. That's right.
So it's actually saving time.
Absolutely right, sir. But that education is still not reaching the customer. It's still not. Though IRCTC mentions on the website, we've got everything mentioned everywhere. They're telling people use the 139 service. During fog, it's highly advocated to people. But still, today when I meet people, till today, when I meet people in a different round, there are some people who do not still know the service. So I always look at more brand ambassadors being created, you know. Because when I tell you 139 once again, you may forget after 1 month, 2 months, 3 months, fir yaad aayega aapko, you'll say, okay, why shouldn't I use the service? And you'll tell 4 people around you if the service is good, right? And I think that is the best form of publicity happening right now. We have worked on from, like I said, December 6th till May 12th. We have also started various things. We have got, like I said, Spot Your Train keyword was launched. The current location in the CRM has been introduced, right? Most importantly, we've done something called a priority circle for VIP customers. VIP customers are not you and me. VIP customers are customers who've been calling up repeatedly for service. If you have called up the service, let's say in the previous 1 year, 20 times, so you become a VIP customer automatically. So you do not need to wait on the IVR to address your question, or through the IVR, you go straight to the agent. Because your comfort levels have already been established. So we're trying to see as to how can he in the CRM be looked after as a priority customer. So VIP is a name just we're just trying to put across. Most importantly, so this is a category one service and a level one service now, as per the DOT. This was a category one, it was not a level one service. Today it's mandatory for all partners to carry this service. Toll number, you pay for it, right? We've also started keeping in mind inquiries, ticket booking, taxis and hotel bookings, value-add services are all getting introduced again because there have been certain delays with partners to establish other things. Ticket bookings are done through us primarily on the cash card. This new problem which occurred a couple of days back, which you people were reading the papers, we're trying to see how can we help the railways to close that too. Because like I said, we only do this business with the railways, nothing else. Bharat BP was created only to do 139, which is IRCTC, was the partner, co-partner here, established through the railway. So we're trying to see how do we make sure ticket bookings happen on a real-time basis through this part, where these touts can be taken out of the system. Because you're actually talking to a secure environment, your credit card is in a secure environment. Still, government is like, the challenges are still there. Like I said, voice SMS is predominant. Right? USSD was something which I was very keen to introduce for quite some time. People were not very, very sure that USSD will take off, but fortunately for us it has. Airtel and Vodafone contribute the maximum to this, followed by BSNL in terms of volumes. So the service is divided, like I said, into three parts, basic inquiry, premium inquiry, and the value-add services. So under basic, we've got train running positions and PNR. Value-add services at availability of Tatkal. We do not charge as per the agreement where we are supposed to be charging on forbearance or 4 rupees and 5 rupees. We don't do that. We address the call right there in the basic inquiry costs because we do not want the customer experience to get spoilt. Because why should I have to pay so high for any service? That is what the predominant part of the service was, led by the organization. Among the 784 queries which we can answer across the railway, this is the reason why people generally call us.
Yeah. Well, if you look, majority of the callers call for PNR and the arrival departure. These are the two major reasons why people call on this number. PNR is one service which we try and service on the IVR primarily, and arrival departure is which we have to give agent access because there are multiple queries that a customer may have on this feature. Now if you look at the IVRS, the easiest thing to punch in onto the mobile is your PNR number. So it's a 10-digit number, so that's why you find that users are very comfortable in using IVRS service for the PNR query. Same way, even if you look at even the SMS service, though the data may not be here, even the SMS service is very, very highly used for PNR query. Yes. When we started the service 4 years back, we were primarily offering voice services. The contribution of voice was almost about 90% and SMS was about 10%. But over time, with data application getting more and more popular with people, you will find that the contribution of the SMS has gone up to almost 2.5 lakh and in fact almost what 4 lakh calls that we receive on the SMS on a daily basis. So the growth on the SMS has been phenomenal. Again, as I said, if you see the data, the PNR query contributes to almost 96% of all SMS calls.
The syntax which is used for PNR is the easiest. You just put your 10-digit number and you SMS it. Compared to the syntax put in for the rest, it's slightly complicated. You may not know the STD code, you may not know the train number, so that's a complication we are trying to do away with. as per the USSC service. Because then you get into one session, which will only cost you 3 rupees. Otherwise, it costs you 5 sessions or 6 sessions, which we are not auditors very happy doing.
Just a small point on how this entire the entire architecture that has been created is that railway has got these 4 zonal hubs on which they have a platform which is the PRS, which is the passengers reservation system, and they have NTS, which is the National Train Inquiry Service. So NTS is the service of railways which provides the real time information on the arrival and departure of the train. And the PRS is what gives you your PNR, your like accommodation availability, etc. So these two servers are linked on online at the back end with servers which are housed at our zonal data centers. So there's a live update happening on a real-time basis. And that's how the information flows from railways.
Each and every call is recorded, keeping in mind quality assurance, each and every call. So whenever you want to check up, when you called up and what happened, you can be given the detail within, I think, about 15 minutes, because you have to just find it out on the date which you called up. That's how fast you can get to know. And you can see, suppose you have an objection to a call, you send email, I was not serviced properly. So you know that, yes, whether you actually were serviced or not. So when there's an inquiry coming in from Parliament, we can answer it very, very fast. So I do get queries from Parliament on a regular basis, which we answer for you.
And for how long do you store this information?
This entire
for the tender, there's a requirement as for the tender that you're supposed to store.
How long is it? 2 years?
Yeah, it is 6 months. 6 months the data is saved.
Huge.
Okay, what we also do is that, you know, when we talk about railway services and we're talking about information, we cannot afford to have a single point of downtime because you are giving a national service. So we have linked all these centers through the MPLS network. So if any one center fails, there is an automatic this redundancy where the entire service can be moved onto the other center. So we have created this entire architecture so that there's a foolproof service. There's zero downtime because you have this backup.
We have taken the total system, telecom. As per the tender, we were supposed to have BSNL, or that time there was nobody else. But for the MPLS, we have taken Airtel as a partner. Right.
So you're not in touch with
Railtel. So Railtel they don't answer back. I have personally gone to the Railtel office, personally, not once, on 14 occasions. But I said, listen,
when did it go last?
2 years back.
No, go now.
Okay.
Taking your thing, we must. Because IRCTC ka jo main office hai, corporate office, right, is at Bank of Baroda building, and they are on the next floor. So even CMD ke saath meeting karayi hai. So let's close this here. So same family, everything is done. Give us a good rate and let's close it.
Hey, kab purani baat hai.
Okay.
In fact, Mr. Muniappa also called up. Right? He's a personal friend. I was sitting with him. He called up. All these guys, let's work out something with our own service. 17 days to answer back to one email. 17 days. Sir, history yaad rehti hai, sir.
Okay, sir, thank you. We'll just take your questions if there are any.
There's only one question that I have. Is, I mean, you've got a 10-year contract, and this is the only contract that you have.
No, I can hear you. Not on tape.
I think he wants it for you. So, having said that, at the end of the 10 years, if you don't get the contract, what happens to Bharat BPO Limited?
Bharat BPO was created only for the Indian Railways.
Yes.
And incorporated in 2006 only for the service.
That contract would go away from Spice Digital to somebody else and continue as Bharat BPO Limited, would that be?
Service quality and the product present. We are pretty sure that It will not go into perpetuity, definitely, but it would move into the next level at the railway board level, because they've seen the consistency of the service and the way we meet the requirements, as well as with the consumer. So there's a total connect. So I don't think when a service is running a hunky-dory, you're making money out of it in terms of the money which you have to pay them as per tender specification every year. They're very unhappy with what is moving ahead.
No, you're telling you need a plan B, risk mitigation strategy.
In this, we really don't want to go in, because if it runs well, good enough for us. Today, I think we got a call the other day from one of the ministers in Bangladesh who has heard of the service.
So now that's
got
an
very,
avenue.
Very excited.
That's an opportunity.
So you're right, because I think this...
that's an opportunity.
Yes.
I think you still need a plan B and a risk mitigation strategy. In this country, we never know.
Thank you once again. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Pleasure being here.
Thank you very much.